Thank you.
So you know, your colleague, ranking member of your committee, is openly questioning whether or not the White House blocked Sally Yates from testifying. Do you believe that to be the case?
Absolutely. And let me just say, with the greatest respect, this isn't Democrats versus Republicans. This is, you can look at it, truth versus absolute fantasy land. I don't know what Mr. Spicer is looking at. It is very obvious the White House wanted this open meeting canceled. They did not want Ms. Yates to speak. They didn't want a repeat of last week's disastrous first meeting, in which Director Comey said there is an investigation, the Russians attempted to help the Trump campaign and hurt Mrs. Clinton, and that there was no truth in the fabrication that President Obama wiretapped Trump Tower. So those are all facts that we've ascertained so far. The fact that the White House has a two-pronged attack on this is pretty obvious, obstruction and distraction.
You say it's obvious. Would you consider that move, just to scrap the hearing with Sally Yates, do you consider that to be a cover-up at all?
Look, it's evidence of a cover-up. It's hard to read their minds, but what it says by its action is we don't want that testimony. We don't want further political damage by others in the intelligence community telling them what happened here. There is no rational explanation for the cancellation of that meeting. To say that there was a meeting already scheduled with Mr. Comey and Mr. Rogers is simply not true. And the brutal fact is there's more than 2 hours in a day. It's what, 2 o'clock, 3 o'clock? We would be done by now. We can meet with more than one person in a day.
Wow. Let me move on, because Congressman, they haven't talked to you since the whole health care since even before I get on to that, just this whole thing erupted, the secret rendezvous with Mr. Nunes on White House ground, you know, not divulging who cleared him to get into the skiff or what exactly he saw. What are your thoughts on what Devin Nunes did that day?
Look, I take no great pleasure in talking about the chairman this way. It's just the facts. I thought the first 2 years he ran the committee that I was a member, he was very fair. Ever since Mr. Trump has become President Trump, honestly, it's been a different story. But what he did was beyond the pale. It makes absolutely no sense. After what Mr. Comey said, that the Trump White House was part of this investigation, the Trump campaign, to go to the White House with information completely. But never mind the fact that he never shared that information, and still not shared that information with staff, with his fellow Republicans, with the ranking member, or any Democrats. And then to get this in some sort of bizarre late-night excursion, it puts, I guess, Bridge of Spies to shame. It's cloak and dagger at a time when the American public should know exactly what took place.
Do you then think he should recuse himself, as ranking member Adam Schiff is suggesting?
I suggest that you keep your chairmanship. At this point, I don't know that you have the trust of the American public to complete this investigation. Recuse yourself, let someone else lead this, and we'll move forward together.
Do you know, Congressman, who would have cleared him to get over to the White House and cleared into that skiff last week? Do you know that information?
I certainly do not. I know as much as anybody who's read the newspapers or watched your programming. It's anybody's guess, and it does not help the credibility of the investigation that it's all a great mystery. What are we trying to hide? Why won't the chairman reveal this? What in the world is the White House worried about with Ms. Yates' testimony? What are they worried about in having this public meeting?
Do you think your committee is imploding, sir?
No, look, the fact of the matter is we knew this was going to be a rough investigation on this side. When someone says, can you go forward? That's not the right question. We must go forward. How we do that is incumbent upon us. All we can do is message and let the American public know exactly what's taking place. It is that pressure that'll make sure this investigation goes forward with credibility.
Congressman Mike Quigley, thank you very much for the time.
Thank you. Take care.
Thank you. We do have more breaking news here coming into us at CNN. We're getting word that the White House has quietly...